I come from Greece. I study at the University of Athens, the capital of ancient Greece. Many of you might have heard it, the National Cappadocian University. I'm a postgraduate student of political philosophy. And the theme I have chosen to present today is a classic political philosophy theme. We will be transferred to the 18th century now, after all the talk about AI, technology, data. We'll go to something more traditional and classic, but I hope equally interesting as the previous talk. So we will delve into 18th century Britain, the 18th century society, and we will talk about some very traditional, very classic political philosophy themes. As I have laid out, I'll endeavor to answer three research questions in this paper, a main one, and two in the end if I have the time. The most important thing I'll try to examine today is, of course, the connection between the theories of Edmund Burke and Lord Bolingbroke. Their theories concern the social contract, the natural society, and natural religion against political society and revealed religion, a whole controversy of the Enlightenment around deism. We will explain, of course, everything down the road. I also try to examine Burke's philosophical depths to Aristotle concerning these issues, mainly prudence, political virtue, and the nature of society. And in the end, if I have the time, I'll try to detect some seminal and precursor romantic opinions in the Burkean theory I'll try to present today, very briefly, of course, and necessary to respect the time, I'll omit several things, not the important ones. So let's get started, because I suspect not everyone naturally is acquainted with this period in political philosophy. I'll try to set some facts first, some basic facts, the when, the where, the who, so we can get accustomed to the frame, the time frame. We are, of course, in the long 18th century. It's called the long 18th century because it usually starts with the Glorious Revolution at the end of the 17th century, 1688, and finishes with the death of George III in 1820. But we will refer to a specific decade today. That is the 1750s. So we are around in the middle of the 18th century. The whole controversy, the whole debate we are going to see happens in London, of course. That is the Kingdom of Great Britain at the time. Of course, as I have already mentioned, we will talk about Lord Bolingbroke and Edmund Burke. The monarch of the period is George II, so we are in the Georgian era, the broader Georgian era. The House of Hanover, the Stuarts are out, the Hanoverians are in, so we are in this period of time, generally speaking. And of course, since the Georgians, the early Georgians, are in, we have the Whigs in power, the period of the Whig ascendancy, with Sir Robert Walpole being the most prominent politician of the time, and of course the Whigs as the ruling power in Parliament. So, as you might see, I use the term party lato sensu because there is a whole controversy that's not relevant right now to our presentation about what is party, what is a political connection, political affiliation. But I'll try to use the word party in a more conventional style, so just to understand what's going on. Moving forward to the specific timeline, to 2 years where the work we will comment, Vindication of Natural Society, is published, we happen to be in 1756 and 1757.